Good afternoon. My name is Ángel Velázquez, and I'm a professor of the Universidad Rey Juan Carlos, Madrid, Spain. As the title of my paper suggests, I'm going to speak about the design of small exercises for the block-based programming language Scratch Junior. Probably you know that according to the academic literature, block-based programming is typically assessed by means of programming projects. However, the research also has found that this is not the best way to learn programming. Instead, alternative approaches have been suggested, and in particular, one of these approaches consists of developing many small programs weekly. The specific type of these small exercises can be inspired by several taxonomies which exist about types of programming exercises. Well, we tried to design small exercises according to these taxonomies, and we found a difficulty, and it's that block-based languages often have different features than textual languages, and therefore it's difficult or even impossible to transform these exercises into a block-based style. In particular, Scratch Junior does not provide variables, so it's impossible to ask about the state of the program execution by looking at the state of variables. So we must use the visible or the audible impact of the execution of a block on the program scenario. In this paper, I'm going to present several types of small exercises for Scratch Junior, which have been designed and which can be automatically assessed. The first kind is of the predictive type, and here the user may ask for the final value of a visible attribute of a character. For instance, in this case, the question asks about how many degrees the character has been rotated. A variation of the previous type are trace exercises, where not only the final state is demanded, but also the sequence of different states. For instance, in this example, we ask for the sequence of sentences which are said by the three characters. Third type of exercises involve understanding, and we have to be careful so that these exercises cannot be solved just by rote, but the user must really understand the contents. For instance, in this case, the user is asked about equivalent sequences of blocks. And finally, the fourth type consists of a different kind of understanding. In this case, the user is asked to translate a written behavior into code. The contrary can also be made. In conclusion, we found the design of small exercises is more challenging than just like a translation of exercises developed for textual languages into block-based languages. We have presented some of the most natural and successful exercises, and currently we are extending the set of programming exercises we have for Scratch Junior and also for Scratch in order to have a comprehensive coverage of the language. In parallel, we are also trying to identify the design guidelines that we are using for the development of these exercises, though that they can serve as a guideline for structures and research. And that's all. Thank you very much.